Do you think we can pack in this little box the power of this 2 kW inverter? Well, our engineers did it.
The Little Box Challenge is an open competition initiated by Google and IEEE in July 2014. And what Google wants is to build an inverter with the highest power density. The minimum requirement is about less than half a liter. Today, a 2 kVA inverter, solar inverter, is about the size of a picnic cooler. So the challenge is to build an inverter roughly 10 times smaller than what is present on the market today. CE+T Power manufactures modular inverters. Our challenge those last 30 years is to reduce the size of our product, have our product more efficient. Today, the best inverters of CE+T is about 4 liters. And our customers cannot afford any interruptions. So the applications of our product is to secure their critical applications in the telecommunications, in the industry, in the data centers, and power utility.
We realized from the beginning that the project was completely new, completely different from what we did before. And so for that reason, we had to change the methodology to address it. We decided to first start with an internal team to develop the inverter itself. Aside to that part of the project, there is also mechanical, thermal, and different things that we are not really specialists of. And so we decided to find a local partner like Ceres, like Microsys, like University of Liège. With that help, we finally get the result we really want to get. I mean, a small box and a very good inverter inside.
For the hardware, obviously, we did everything very small. For semiconductor, we choose new nitride of gallium. And for thermal aspect, we optimize honeycomb heating. Also, for storage energy, we decide to use new ceramic capacitor that use also for thermal dissipation.
Concerning the EMC filter, because of the reduction of the size, we needed to implement a specific customized shielding. In order to save time, we asked our partners to make a lot of simulations for us. Electronic simulation, but also thermal simulation. As an example, we tested several types of heatsink in order to choose the best one. It turned out it was the honeycomb model.
As far as software is concerned, we had to develop new control strategies to control the new components, and that was quite difficult. If we want to reduce the size of an inverter, we have to do a lot of calculation very fast with a limited processing power, so we had to optimize all the algorithms.
The time frame was by September 2014 to be registered as a team. So we were registered among 2,000 teams. Then by July 2015 to deliver a technical report and a testing report, which we delivered 5 days prior to the date. In September 2015, we were officially announced being part of the 18 finalists by Google, and we were invited by October 2015 to present and deliver the prototype in the NREL laboratory in Colorado. We were very impressed by the presentations of the other participants, but we are very confident about the result of the challenge for CE+T. Well, early in February, Google called us to notify that we were part of the last 405 who succeeded to pass all the tests and invited us in Washington, February 29, to participate to the IEEE summit where the winner was announced. We were very surprised and happy to learn that we won. This really demonstrates the leadership that we are having in power conversion in the industry. It is a clear indication of our ambitions and how our know-how will serve our customer in the future.
As an engineer, it was very interesting to have the opportunity to work on that project. We had to make a new inverter from scratch, and that was very exciting.
This was a personal challenge to be within the 18 finalists. It was really great to work with the team. Everybody was enthusiastic to work.
It was a great challenge, and we already noticed that we use some of the techniques that have been developed in the Little Box Challenge in the product that we will release shortly.